We're going to be talking about Rekenreks. It's the name for a small abacus-like math tool. The Rekenrek is pronounced Reken, but it actually looks like our English version of the form to reckon, and it means to calculate, add up, total, or count, or number. The Rekenrek is a math tool that helps develop conceptual understanding in young children. It's actually made up of two rows of stringed beads. As you can see in the picture, there's a repeating pattern of five beads of one color and five beads of another color on each row. You begin with the first five colored beads to help students subitize. You use one row to build up fluency to 10, and you use two rows to build fluency to 20. So let's talk about what does it mean to subitize. To subitize means to see the quantity of something. We want to see the quantity of the colored beads. Then what is fluency? Fluency is knowing how a number is composed and decomposed. It's also the ability to use our knowledge about the number. If we want to define these terms a little bit more, subitize means that we can help children learn to see a quantity or a set of objects without even counting them. Most of us can subitize up to five objects. So the Rekenrek is five red beads and five white beads, which actually helps children learn to see or visually identify these quantities up to five. Fluency means knowing how a number is composed or decomposed so that we can put it together and take it apart. This helps children develop more flexibility and efficiency in order to solve problems. So let's look at what it would look like on a Rekenrek. Let's try one. Let's say that we want to look at the number 7. 7 actually looks like 5 and 2 more. We have 5 red beads. We add 2 to that number. So we're actually contextualizing or composing and decomposing these numbers. Then if we look at the second example, we're looking at 13. 13 looks like 10 and 3 more. So we have 10 beads on the top row and 3 on the bottom row. We could also show it with our two rows of red beads. 5 red beads and 5 red beads would be 10 red beads, and then 3 more white beads would show our 5. So it's again helping us to learn how to compose and decompose numbers. We can actually practice using the number 4. So we have different variations. We could ask children who had a Rekenrek in their lap to show us different ways they could make 4, and they might show it with 3 red beads on top and 1 on the bottom, or 1 red bead on top and 3 on the bottom, or a combination of 2 on the top and 2 on the bottom. So you help them think of different ways that they can make the same number. Here's another example of other ways that they might show on their Rekenrek. So if you're doing this with children, you might ask them to show you multiple ways, and they can keep incorporating that and learning how to make sense of numbers. So let's think then about how you can use Rekenreks in your classroom.